Welcome. In this lecture, we would understand Biological Diversity Act 2002. Now, first of all, let's understand why knowing about biodiversity is so important. India is one of the 12 nations which is known for its mega diverse population or mega diverse flora and fauna across the country, right? With only 2.5% of the land area across the globe, we account for 7.8% of the total world species. That means we have a very huge biodiversity. Now, the basis for this act lies in the Convention for Biodiversity, the Convention for Biological Diversity, which was released in 1992. Now, it recognizes the rights of the state to use their own biological resources and to facilitate the access of genetic resources to the party nations. Now, this convention was brought in 1992. However, there were parties which agreed to it, and this was under the Article 3 and 15 of the Convention of the Biological Diversity Act. However, later on, the center brought in the Biological Diversity Act 2002, and this was traced from the basis of the Convention of Biological Diversity, and this which was the CBD, which was signed at the Rio conference in 1992, formed the basis for the Biological Diversity Act. Now, why the new act, that is the Biological Diversity Act, is important? The major reason is it talks about a framework where you can implement the objectives. Now, what are the objectives? So, there are threefold objectives that are taken into account. The first is conservation of the genetic resources. The second is sustainable use of the genetic resources and the natural forest areas, and then equitable sharing of the benefits. This is one of the most important clause that we would discuss here, because whatever benefits are being obtained from the forest area have to be equitably shared. That means not equal, it is equitably. When I say equal, everyone gets, like there are two people, everyone would get half. That is what is equal. But what is equitable? Equitable, the word means that, let's say this person requires one third. So he would get one third because he has access to other ample resources. But the other person requires more, so he would get two third. But that is as per the need of an individual. In simple terms, I'm trying to explain what is the difference between equal and equitable, right? So here, the idea is equitable sharing of the benefits for the resources. So this Biological Diversity Act, the implementation came with this threefold concept. Now, what are the major aims and objectives? As we mentioned, to regulate the biological resources of the country, have an equitable benefit, equitable share of benefits, sustainable use, which we already said. Another important thing is what is in very light these days, indigenous knowledge system. That means protecting the knowledge of the local communities, sharing the benefits with the local people, conserving the areas and the heritage sites, rehabilitating the threatened species, and involving institutions for implementation of the programs under Biological Diversity Act. So, prior to the Biological Diversity Act and post Biodiversity Act, what are the major things that we would account for? So, before this act, the Constitution under Article 51 makes it an obligation for the nation to respect international treaties and international agreement. So India's obligation is in alignment to the Convention on Biological Diversity, which was adopted in 1992, and India became a signatory in 1994. So under our Article 51, where we have an obligation to respect the international treaty, we need to have a framework where this could be implemented. There was a judiciary case of T.N. Godavarman Tirumalpad versus the Union of India, and Supreme Court said that the role of government in taking international conventions would be important while construing the local or the domestic laws, right? Now, this was the thing that had happened before the Biological Diversity Act 2002. However, after that, there have been substantial movements for legally focusing on issues which were related to human activities in the biodiversity areas and having a NGT, which is the National Green Tribunal, which would be specialized as an effective body to understand and expedite the issues of environmental jurisprudence. And this would also talk about policy interventions. It would also talk about and focus on financial commitments, correct? Now, what are some of the important terms that have been explained under the Biological Diversity Act? This is under section